I want to show you three really cool things about essential oils and why people are really turning back to them for solutions to help them get back on track with healthy, empowered living. The first cool thing about essential oils is they're natural. All essential oils are made from plants: the leaf, the stem, the flower, or the root. Nothing is taken away from or added to these oils, so they're 100% natural. If you look on your class guide, you're going to see a picture of a peppermint leaf. Next to that, you're going to see a magnified peppermint leaf. Now, what you're looking at is these little tiny oil sacs on each plant. These oil sacs protect the plant against predators and viruses and bacteria, and it actually keeps the plant healthy. Similarly, when you and I use these essential oils, we get that same protection. Now I want you to take some peppermint. Take that peppermint sample, and I want you to open it up, and I want you to put a drop in your hands, just like this. Then I want you to rub your hands together, cup your hands around your face, don't touch your eyes, and don't get it too close to your face, and I want you to breathe it in deeply for 30 seconds. What I want you to do as you're breathing it in really deeply is I want you to take note of what you're feeling as you do this. You'll likely feel your airways open. Maybe you're going to become a little bit more alert. Head tension might be relieved. Peppermint is really versatile, just like most oils. As you felt, it's great to support respiratory health and open airways. It's great for tension. It also helps aid in digestive issues, and it is awesome for a natural coolant. So if you're a female in a particular season of life that's a little bit hotter, peppermint is fabulous. You just take it, rub the rest of that you have right now, rub it in the back of your neck, and in a minute, you'll feel it cooling you off. Moms love using doTERRA peppermint to really aid in cooling down their children when they're sick. Here's what I love about essential oils. They're 50 to 70 times more potent than herbal supplements. Now remember, that's where my expertise was for years. That one drop that you just tried is actually equivalent to drinking 28 cups of peppermint tea. Where you and I would have to take numerous supplements, you just need a drop or a couple drops to do the exact same thing. So the first cool thing about essential oils is they're natural. The second cool thing about essential oils is they're effective. Okay, let's go all the way back to Biology 101 to learn about the effectiveness of oils. If you're a doctor, nurse, or biologist, or scientist listening to this, I am not trying to offend you by the simplicity of this, but we're gonna keep this really simple and on a level that we all can understand. There are two paths that most of us take when it comes to our health: the medical path, which deals with symptoms, and the natural pathway, which really focuses more on the root causes. I absolutely believe that there is a time and a place for the medical model for sure, but I'm gonna operate now under the assumption that you're listening to this because you want a lifestyle of health and wellness, and we'd probably both agree that we can only achieve that through living things, things that are alive. Medication is non-living, it's synthetic, and synthetic things have what? They have side effects. So we wanna reach our goal of health and wellness and feeling good with no side effects. Let me tell you two reasons why essential oils work so well. Number one, oils contain hundreds of compounds in each one, so they're extremely versatile to help you with numerous issues at once. So let's take peppermint, for example. It has nearly 300 unique compounds. This is why it can help you with headaches and digestive issues at the exact same time. This is very different than medication, which really hits one symptom, but then it also has that side effect. Oils hit numerous root issues with no side effects. Let me tell you a little story about willow bark. There was a tribe in the Middle East years ago that discovered that willow bark was great for pain. And they used it, they crushed it up and they used it. And there was another company that came in and realized what this tribe was doing. They began to study willow bark and they discovered these hundreds and hundreds of compounds of willow bark that made it so effective. But this company could not mimic all of the hundreds of compounds because science hasn't quite figured out a way to do that yet. But they looked at it and they isolated a couple of those compounds. They synthetically reproduced them in a lab, and then they added a bunch of other chemical things in it so that they could patent it. And that company that we have today is called Bayer. That's where we got aspirin from. So when you look at the roots of a lot of our pharmaceutical drugs, they're plant-based, but they're synthetically produced from the natural thing, and it never quite touches all of the compounds because we haven't figured out how to really duplicate that yet. So they're less effective in the long run. Oils are super effective because they can penetrate the cell wall and provide the cell what it needs to support health. Inside of our bodies are millions of cells that are each surrounded by an oily membrane. It's a bilipid or double layer of fat. Now, this membrane's job is to protect the cell and guard what comes in and what comes out. Let's say you get sick with a bacteria. What does the doctor give you? He gives you an antibiotic. 8 to 10 days later, hopefully you're feeling better. But that antibiotic has what? It has a side effect. It does its job well and it kills the bad bacteria, but it also kills the good bacteria in your intestines. But what happens when you get a virus? The doctor tells you to go home and rest and just let it run its course, and you're absolutely miserable. So bacteria actually form on the outside of your cell. If you look at your class guide, it's this little green guy on the outside of the cell. And inside of the cell is the virus. It's the purple guy that kind of hangs out inside of the cell. Most antibiotics are water-based, which is why they don't work on viruses, because oil and water don't mix. But essential oils can actually penetrate the oily membrane and support the body and immune function from the inside and outside of the cell. One of my favorite oils that does this is doTERRA's On Guard. It's a blend of oils that smells a little bit like Christmas in a bottle, and it supports a healthy immune system. This is a daily use oil in our home, especially in Tennessee during the months of September through March, where seasons are changing and when school is in full swing and so are the germs. So what are the two things that we've just learned about essential oils? They're natural and they're effective. The third cool thing about essential oils is that they're safe. There are 4 different grades of essential oils. Remember, not all oils are the same. The first type that we have is synthetic. This would be perfumes, lavender air fresheners, lemon furniture polish. Remember again, synthetic things have side effects, even things like household cleaners, laundry detergents, and skincare products that we probably don't think about. The second type is food-grade essential oils. Orange frosting, lemon bars, basil or oregano in spaghetti sauce, but it only has to be the grass quality, which is generally regarded as safe to be able to put it into our food. The third grade is therapeutic. This is what you might find at a massage or chiropractic office or in stores for relaxing or reducing stress. These types are very unregulated and they have limited or really marginal health benefits. The fourth type, our last one, is certified pure therapeutic grade. This is medical grade of essential oils, and it is the highest quality grade. Not many oils pass this test. What makes doTERRA certified pure therapeutic grade the highest standard is a few things. Our oils are third-party tested, they're free of contaminants and heavy metals, and they're beyond organic. Also, CPTG means that our plants are grown and harvested in their natural environment all over the world. Why is that a big deal? Well, have you ever had a pineapple in Hawaii? It tastes nothing like the pineapple that you buy at Kroger in Nashville, Tennessee. The reason for this is that plants are adaptive to the environment that they're placed in. Pineapple will grow in other places than Hawaii, but it will change the compound structure of the plant, which in turn changes the health benefits you and I receive. doTERRA sources from 42 different countries around the world to give you and I the oils that are going to have the best compound structure to work with your body and produce the best results. Our lemon oil, for example, it's grown in Italy. Our Melaleuca from Australia. Lavender is actually best grown in the high altitudes of France and Bulgaria. And our frankincense that is best for supporting inflammation comes from the Middle East. It would be so much easier and cheaper to grow the oils here in the U.S. But know this, the purest oils produce the best natural medicine. Let's talk for just a second about price. Have you ever thought, I can't afford essential oils, they're way too expensive? I want to show you how I can beat the best insurance that you have nearly every time and save you money by using essential oils. So what's your copay? Take a second and write that down. Now, how much do you pay for medication? Maybe you get yours for $5 or $10, or maybe you even get yours for free. Then, if you get sick, how long do you have to take that medication or antibiotic? Probably 8 to 10 days. So that's some time off work, right? So if my child has an ear infection, I can take 2 drops of Melaleuca, 2 drops of lavender. I can rub it on the inside or the outside and inside of their ear, and it costs me 64 cents. So even if you get your over-the-counter drugs for free with the insurance plan you have, I have you beat in the cost of the gas to the drive to the store, or the time you had to take off work when you didn't feel well or had to pick your child up from school. So do the math for yourself over the course of a year. If you weren't investing in regular copays and medication and doctor's visits, what would you have saved over that year since oils are only pennies per drop? So you just heard three cool things about essential oils. They're natural, they're effective, and they're safe. I also showed you that they're really cheap.